Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about Audie Murphy. Audie Murphy is the most decorated soldier to ever live. After the attack on Pearl Harbor, he really wanted to fight for the U.S. military. The military did not accept him because of he was underage, short, and tiny. His sister faked his birth certificate to make him look like he was older. Then finally, the U.S. military accepted him. He was sent to the Mediterranean theater acting as a platoon messenger. Few weeks later, he was in a landing assault craft heading to Sicily. The weather was horrible and the Germans did not expect a landing in this crazy weather. While on scouting patrol, he came across two fleeing Italian soldiers. Audie shot and killed them. Audie was diagnosed with a serious illness, forcing him to stay in a hospital for a week. Then he was sent to Salerno. When he landed, he and some other soldiers were ambushed by a few Germans. Immediately, one of the soldiers got shot and killed. He and another soldier killed all of the Germans. Murphy and his men was attacked by seven German soldiers. They killed three and took four prisoners. Because of this, he was promoted to sergeant. Just 1 month later, he was promoted to staff sergeant. He was diagnosed with malaria, causing him to stay in the hospital for a week and a half. He rejoined his men at the First Battle of Cisterna, which was an American defeat. Then, he and his unit took shelter in a farmhouse. A German panzer discovers their position. Monty crawled out alone with rifle grenades and destroyed the tank. Because of this, he was awarded the Bronze Star with V device. Then he participated in D-Day. Murphy and his platoon made it through the beach and into a French vineyard. Suddenly, German soldiers opened fire at them. Murphy's machine gunner was separated from Murphy's unit and needed backup. Murphy ran through the swarm of bullets and retrieved the machine gunner's weapon and opened fire at the Germans. Two Germans went out of the house pretending to surrender. Murphy's friend went up to take the Germans prisoner without knowing that they're pretending. Suddenly, Germans in the house shot and killed his friend. Murphy was really angry since the Germans killed his friends and alone rushed into the house and killed six Germans, wounded two, and took 11 prisoners. Because of this, he and his unit was awarded the Presidential Unit Citizen. On the 15th of September, he was injured by a mortar shell and forced into a hospital. A few weeks later, he rejoined his unit. He was then awarded a Silver Star and for taking over a German machine gun position. Then he and his unit was trying to take over a heavily defended hill. He went alone to get a closer view of the hill, and he directed his men how and where to attack via radio. While Germans were pouring machine gun fire for an hour at him. For his heroism, he was promoted to second lieutenant and was awarded a bronze oak leaf cluster for a silver star. The Allies were beginning to win the war. Murphy was near Paris when a brutal battle began. A strong German attack has begun. Murphy called for any backup possible. A few M10 tank destroyers responded, but was slowly destroyed by Panzerschreck, a German anti-tank weapon. Then Murphy ordered all of his men to hide in the woods. He alone was fighting a really strong attack. He shot with his rifle and also called for artillery. He knew he couldn't hold off them just using his rifle, so he climbed on top of a burning tank to reach a 50 caliber machine gun on top. For an hour, Murphy stayed on top of the tank, manning the 50-caliber machine gun. He only left because the tank was out of ammo. He killed and wounded over 50 Germans and destroyed more than 3 vehicles. Then he ordered his men to fight back, and he and his men destroyed the Germans. The Germans have to retreat. When Murphy decided to attack again, Murphy refused to go to the field hospital. For his bravery that day, he was awarded the highest U.S. military award, the Medal of Honor, only given to soldiers who have shown much heroism and was willing to sacrifice their lives. After the war, Audie became an actor. Sadly, on May 28, 1971, Audie died because of a plane crash. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share.